Hey everybody, welcome to Easter week, Devo. It's Tuesday. It's awesome. This week is also known as Passion Week. This is the week before Jesus went to the cross. It's the lead up to him laying down his life for you and for me. And I believe right here, right now, there's somebody that doesn't believe that, by the way. And I believe that somebody that's listening right here doesn't have a relationship with God. And that's amazing that you're listening in on this. I just want us all to realize that this is a safe place, that Concord is a safe place, that really the church is a safe place for people that don't know God and do know God. Because there was a moment where those people that do know God didn't know God, and we all had to come to a point where we're honest. And we ask real questions, and we really see what Jesus is about, and we really have some misunderstandings that we have put to the side because we hear the truth about who Jesus is, what he says about us, how he really lived, and what he wants for us now. And so right here, right now, I just want us to maybe just to press time out, like press pause on this world around us. And I want us to just to focus for a second, just to dial in. Just dial it in and see what God would have for us midday on a Tuesday. And I want us to look at what he would be doing around midday on a Tuesday that would be leading him to the cross. So what was he doing 2,000 plus years ago, Jesus specifically, doing about this time? I'll tell you right now, he was talking to people. He was in conversation with people, teaching and helping them understand who he was. And I love that because if somebody's true to themselves, real about who they are, they just want to be known for who they are. They don't necessarily always want other people's opinions to come up about them. It's just we just want to make sure that everyone knows us for who we are. And I love that about Jesus because he was real, and he was honest, and he was true. And I believe right now we're gonna look at just really two verses together. And just pull something very simple, but I think something very powerful for the ones who are ready to apply something to their life, for the ones that are really ready to have God move in their life. And so right now, just before we go into these two verses, I want to pray for us, and I want to pray for all of us on the range from hating God, maybe even being far from God or hating church, to the people who love God, love the church, maybe even just frustrated about their world, about what's going on around us. And wherever you are, this is for you. And so let God move right where you are. So press focus and press pause on what's going on around you. Let me pray. God, I pray right now that you would move. I pray that your word would come alive to us. I pray that we would be able to focus. I pray that we would be able to take notes. I pray that we would be able to encourage each other. I pray that we would be able to dial in and to hear from you. So God, do what only you can do in these moments because there is a camera involved and I'm not with people right now. I'm just talking to a screen, but God, we're okay with that because your word transcends a camera. Your word transcends just this moment. And so right now, we're just going to be honest about this. We're not together, but we are together. And you're going to do something so cool right here, right now. So do what only you can do, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So I'm going to read out of Luke chapter 19, verses 47 and 48. So listen to this. Verse 47, he taught daily in the temple, but the leading priests, the teachers of the religious law, and the other leaders of the people began planning how to kill him. So Jesus was teaching daily. I don't know if you're like me or if you're probably smarter than me, just to be honest. It took me a while to realize that every day I was learning. Like, I didn't realize that. And so I was letting things in my life teach me without even realizing it. And then I didn't really want to learn from them. I was letting things come into my thoughts. I was letting things come into my life. And I didn't really need those things to affect me, to affect how I felt, to affect my emotions, to affect how I lived. And so I was listening to things that I didn't need to listen to. And I was learning from them. And I wasn't learning or listening to the people who care about me most, the people that love me almost more than I love me, and the people that want more for me than I want more for me. And it took me a while to realize that in life, that we're always learning and we're always being taught something, no matter where we are, no matter what we're going through. And we can determine what we listen to, we can determine how we listen, and we can determine who we listen to. And so right here, right now, I just want us to maybe think about that. Because I don't know if you're like some other people in my life, but they come to me and they say, hey, Trevor, like, I don't know what to do with my schedule because everything is crushed together. I never stop working. I never stop being a parent. I never stop being a friend. Yet I'm not physically around people. And I feel like I'm busier than ever, or I feel like I'm bored than ever before. I feel like people are really just the extremes right now. There's really no middle ground. And so for everybody, whether you're bored out of your mind or you feel like you're busier than ever and you're struggling, or you feel like things are going really well and really fast in life, we're kind of on ends of the spectrum. We're either dealing with something heavy or we're dealing with growth and energy and this craziness and this time that's going on around us is pushing us forward. Wherever you are on the spectrum, I want to encourage you this. Be taught daily, but you determine who you're taught by. And begin to listen to Jesus and to begin to listen to who he is and understand what he's trying to tell us. Because there's something amazing that happens right here, right now that I want us to catch. Listen to this. They began planning on how to kill him, the end of verse 47 and in 48. But they could think of nothing because all of the people hung on every word he said. So if you're determining on your focus, and if you're focusing on Jesus, then the things that are going to try and lead you away from him, the things that are going to lead you into the negativity, into sin, into the struggle, into the depression, into the anxiety, those things that are going to lead you that way, if you're focused on Jesus, those things will have nothing again to come up against you to get you away from him, because you'll be so focused on Jesus that you won't be able to have any time to focus on any of those things. Oh, this is huge. Because right here, right now, you can set your calendar, whether work is overtaking your life or anxiety is taking over your life, whether your family is kind of just in a chaos in your house and you're trying to figure out what to do or whatever, you can set your calendar and you can be taught by Jesus in the morning, at midday, at night, or whenever it fits your calendar best, your rhythm of grace, if you will, out of Matthew 11, 28 through 30. You can find your rhythm right here, right now. And Jesus, before he went to the cross, he thought it was important enough to teach people daily so that people could understand who he really was. And he was about to go through the most difficult time of his life. And I would say some of us think it's the most difficult times of our life right now. The struggle is very real for us all. On ends of spectrums. But you can determine who you're listening to and what you're listening to and what you're allowing to come into your life. And those negative, those evil, those stressful, those overwhelming, that depression, all of those things that are trying to come into your life, if you're focused on Jesus, they won't have a space to come into your life. They'll have nothing against you. And we need to know who Jesus is right here, right now, more than ever before. And so as we look at this time of our life, what are you focusing your life on? Are you focusing on Jesus? Or are you focusing on the rules and the things that you feel like you have to do? Or are you focusing on what matters most? Because what matters most right here, right now, is knowing this, I believe, about Jesus. And it's in John 3:17. God sent his son, Jesus, into the world, not to judge the world, but to save the world through him. So Jesus didn't come here. He didn't go through what he was going through 2,000 plus years ago on a Tuesday, going to a Sunday and a Saturday into the cross. He didn't come into the world to judge you. He didn't come into the world to point an accusing finger at you, to saying, oh, like, why did you let this happen? Or look how terrible you are. Or look how much anxiety is in your life. Or look how depressed you are. Or look how much you hate yourself. No, no, no. He's not judging you for those things. He's coming into this world so that you know him. And so you know and let him make your life right again and save you from those things. To help you right now where you are. To put the world right again. So will you let him? comes down to knowing who he is, knowing what he wants for you, and just knowing him and having a real relationship with him. So daily focus on him. Daily spend time being honest with him. And daily see him for who he really is, and not who someone else says he is, or your opinions in the past about who he is, but for who he says that he is and what he wants for you right here, right now, wherever you are, and whenever you're watching this. I believe God is moving in your life if you let him. So let me pray for that for you right here, right now. Wherever you are, will you close your eyes? Will you let me pray for you and just listen to these words? God, I pray for every single person listening to me right here, right now. I pray that the comfort of your character and how much you love them begins to come into their life like never before. So God, do what only you can do and reach them where they are. And God, I pray that everyone listening to me is honest about where they are, what they need, and what they're going through. God, meet them right there in that moment. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you for joining me. I hope you have a great Tuesday. And I hope you hear from God. Thank you so much. Talk to you later.